In this lesson, we will learn how to edit and display the SketchUp toolbars differently. In this example, I have created a new file based on the sample meters template. As you can see, only the main toolbar is currently displayed. To see the rest of the toolbars, I will expand the View menu and click on the Toolbars option. Automatically, the Toolbars window appears, from which I can see all the available toolbars I can display. To display a toolbar, click on the checkbox to the left of its name. In this example, I will display the Large Toolset toolbar, which automatically docks on the left of the window and contains all the main editing and design tools. I will also select the Section toolbar, which contains commands that have to do with creating sections, and the Solid Tools toolbar, which contains tools for editing solid objects. Finally, I will select the Views command containing all the view options. On the right side of the window, there are three options: Reset, Reset All, and New. With the Reset option, you can restore a toolbar to its initial state if it has been edited. With the Reset All option, you can restore all toolbars to their initial state. Finally, with the new option, you can create your own customized toolbar that will contain the commands you wish to contain. To get a clearer picture of these options, let's move on to an example. I will click on New to create a new toolbar. In the Toolbar Name field of the window, I will type the name of the toolbar. In this example, I will type My Toolbar, and then I will click OK. Notice that the toolbar appears, but it is empty. To fill the toolbar with the commands, all I need to do is click on the icon of the command I want, let's say, the outer shell from the Solid Tools toolbox, and while holding down the mouse button, I will drag the icon to the new toolbox. Notice that the icon has been moved from the Solid Tools toolbox to my toolbar. If you want to copy instead of moving an icon, hold down the Control button while dragging to the new location to create a copy. In this way, you can create as many toolbars as you want and add the tools you want. Now, to delete the toolbar I created, I will select it from the Toolbars window, and then I will click on the Delete button. A message appears that asks if we really want to delete the toolbar. In my case, I will select Yes. As you can see, the toolbar has been deleted. Now, because the Solid Tools toolbar has been modified, to restore it, I will select it from the Toolbars window and click Reset. In the message that appears, I will click Yes, and you will notice that I have restored the toolbar to its original state. At this point, I will show you the two options on the Options tab of the Toolbars window. When the first option, Show Screen Tips on Toolbar, is enabled, every time you hover over any icon, information about that command will be displayed. I will leave this option enabled and click Close. Now I will hover the cursor over a command and notice that the application displays information about that specific command. I will then open the Toolbars window again and disable that option. Notice now that nothing is displayed. I will then open the Toolbars window again and enable that option, as I want the information to be displayed. The second option, Large Icons, has to do with the size of the tool's icons. When it is enabled, the icons appear larger, so I will not disable it and I will close the window. A faster way to display a toolbar is to right-click on a displayed toolbar and select the next toolbar you want to display from the menu that appears. You can also close a toolbar in the same way, right-click on a displayed toolbar and deselect the toolbar you don't need to appear in the application window. In this example, I will close the Getting Started toolbar since it contains the same tools as the Large Toolset toolbar. I will not change the current position of the Large Toolset toolbar, but I will carefully place the other toolbars at the top of the drawing area. To move a toolbar, you have to simply click on it and drag it to the desired location.